Thank you, and thank you, Shivatsa, for inviting me to Bangalore. I've never been to a coffee board event or a tea board event or anything of the sort. So it's quite, and that's germane to what I'm going to say. So it's nice to be here at a time which is very convenient to navigate the airport traffic also. You managed to get in just in time in that 3-hour window you guys have before your city breaks into hell. I normally avoid coming to Bangalore for that reason, but thank you. And I can escape early in the morning before your city breaks. But tomorrow is Gandhi Jayanti, so one should be okay. And I would especially like to sort of recognize the coffee growers who are here. I think much of what I'm going to say, I hope, and our study will be directed really at you. So before I come to subsidies, let me start with telling you two things, interesting things. One about my past. I lived in Brazil for 3 years. And as you know, Brazil is, I think, the world's largest producer of coffee. And for, I ended up buying coffee from Devans in Delhi. Not because I didn't want to buy Brazilian coffee, but because Brazilian coffee, good Brazilian coffee, was simply not available in Brazil. All of it was being exported. And the first thing I want to say is that if India is growing at 14% a year, and if coffee drinking, as it appears, seems to be on the rise, it's always been the case, farmers in Delhi, which is far away from you, I hate having a cup of coffee in a bhavan in Delhi, because it's always Nescafe, not even brew. But it is prestigious. So if you're an honored guest, they give you coffee. If you're a normal guest, they give you tea. So given this sort of prestige value for coffee, I think it is also very important going forward that we don't become like Brazil, that we are actually able to make sure that what is happening today, and that's my second point, this card is from my hotel. I'll shame the hotel. It's La Meridian. And it says I can get a free cup of coffee anytime in the La Meridian, but a cup of Ely coffee. In the home of the coffee board, no mention of any Indian coffee. I mean, I'm sure you're selling into Ely, as Brazil does, but nobody will know. And this is interesting, right? So there is a whole domestic market, which is whose tastes are growing. It's about 40, 50 million people. And I can promise you that at a macroeconomic level, I'm a macroeconomist, if even half of them start drinking Ely and Lavazza, even if you know part of your coffee is inputs into that, it's a net import, that's not going to be very good for a balance of payments. And therefore, I would also urge you to think about the domestic market as it grows. On subsidies, let me preface my comment by a larger quest I'm doing on for the Prime Minister, which is I have been for a long time worried that India's entire growth and prosperity over the last 27 years has been based on the demand, the demands of the top 50 to 100 million people. Whether it is four-wheelers or air conditioners or fridges, these have been the sort of growth impulses. But if you ask what all Indians want to consume, not rich or poor, then you have, in my view, five things. Everyone wants to consume a square, nutritious meal. Everyone wants to consume clothing. Everyone wants to consume, everyone wants a house. Everyone wants healthcare and education. But most important, most Indians don't want to get this through handouts from government. I don't get a handout from government to eat my food, buy clothing, buy a house, secure health, secure education. Why should then people who earn at least the minimum wage rely on a handout from government to consume these five things, which is the situation today? They also have dignity. Nobody likes going to government for a subsidy and chasing around IAS officers and begging of, you know, or BDOs as the case may be. Nobody likes that, you know. The IAS officers wouldn't know because they don't have to do it. But I know, since I'm a public citizen, that it is something I like to avoid. I'd rather not do something than, you know, go around chasing government. Sometimes, you know, there's a big program in Delhi. Delhi is a very funny city. You can't buy a ticket for half the prestigious programs that happen there. You have to get a pass. And for a pass, you have to go and beg from government. So I don't go. You know, so moving to a market economy means from your pocket going and buying something for which prices have got to be affordable. Now in agriculture, for the last 7 months, I have a team working on what is the non-subsidized price of a nutritious square meal. Not a poor person's meal. An average meal. In this place it would be, you know, kutu, dal, rice, some snacks in the morning, a cup of coffee in South India. Right, so any package you take. And I have been unsuccessful. Why? Because there are so many subsidies and interventions that have occurred in agriculture for the last 60 years since our independence. So many. that we simply don't know what the price of a square meal is. And I think the subsidies investigation into coffee is very important for that, and I'm reaching out to you as farmers. It is short-term convenient, but in the long-term, it is in our common interest to know what is the price at which you can, people can buy a cup of coffee and you can sell coffee without worrying about a government handout and earn a good living. And if we find that it is impossible for you to do that in the study, then we will convey this to the coffee board saying we have a serious problem. And if we find there are pathways for you to do what I'm sure you would like to do, which is see the end of the coffee board in 20 years and every board in this country, and be able to sell your coffee as a farmer and maybe not buy a BMW, at least be able to buy, I don't know, a Maruti Desire or whatever it is, you know, a sort of reasonable car, or you will probably need a four-wheel drive, see a hospital in the area because there's enough prosperity, send your children to a good school, all with your earnings as a farmer, and only rely on public intervention when things fall apart because of weather or something like that. Then we are in a better world, right, you and I, than a world in which we don't even know whether we are grown-up children or not, whether we're independent of government or not. And for that, of course, a lot of work has to happen. Srivatsa was highlighting it. I think Ramanan was highlighting it. There's a lot of work that needs to be done to get Indian coffee on the map, make sure you guys have access to marketing, improve your infrastructure access, make sure that diseases only occur as a consequence of a chance event and are not avoidable. So many things need to be done. I'm not denying that at all. And that is where we need to spend our money. So my study will focus on subsidies. But the objective of focusing on subsidies will be to ask a question, which is, it is the right of every coffee farmer in this country who knows their business to be able to earn a decent living and be in the top 80 million income earners in this country without a subsidy. What is the problem? I know you don't want a subsidy. Why would you want to go to a BDO? Why would you want to come to the coffee board? I don't. Why would you? We are all in the same boat. So if, and that's what I like about Srivatsa, that I know he's with me 100% in this endeavor. He'd like nothing better than to be the last secretary of the coffee board, but that is going to take some time. But that is a good idea, you know, getting rid of boards, etc. I don't have a, you know, how do I put it? Do I have an alcohol board? No. I don't have an alcohol board. No, I don't have a malt whiskey board, right? I have a board of film certification, but I don't have a board to promote Indian film because people go, they use their money, they buy it, and producers of films are rich. Same is what I want of coffee makers. So that is my endeavor. And in that endeavor, so I wanted you, please, in the farming community to broadcast this. So when we come to you, we will be asking questions about subsidies with this in mind. We also realize that this is not just a matter of specific coffee subsidies. There are complicated matters like the fertilizer subsidy. So, Secretary of Agriculture is here, you're here from the Commerce Ministry, and it's a difficult question. We know that you are in a quandary as farmers. We know there are countless notes, believe it or not, from the Fertilizer Ministry in Delhi, that the kind of fertilizer subsidy mix we are providing is not helping the farmer. We know it is bad. We know we are in a bad monopsonistic situation within the fertilizer market. So there's that larger problem of subsidies to crack. What I'll be doing at the larger level of agriculture subsidies is trying to see how it impacts you and then pointing out where the impact is negative, because that's nothing you can do about it or the coffee board can, and how to counteract it. The final thing that we will be looking at when we look at subsidies, hopefully, since I've lived in Brazil, is there a level playing field? Is it the case that there are subsidies in other coffee growing areas, sometimes in collaboration with coffee consuming areas, which, you know, tilt the playing field against you? So I'm hoping we'll do a thorough examination of subsidies in Brazil, subsidies in Colombia, subsidies in, although they don't grow Arabica, subsidies in Vietnam, but I don't think you're in the same business, right? Our coffee is all Arabica, right? Vietnam is not Arabica, most of it. And put to the attention of the coffee board if there are any cross subsidies. Mr. Saravanan can then take that to commerce, and then we can take it up in WTO, and luckily most of them are developing countries. So, and I want to make one final point. I would like to join with Mr. Ramanan in a common endeavor, whether it's the subsidies thing we are doing or the roadmap for Indian coffee. There is no Indian coffee brand abroad. And when I heard that you are supplying to Ely, I'll be very honest, it depressed me. Now, there's a conflict of interest here, of course, because I'm a great coffee drinker, and I like the fact that I have some of the world's best coffee, and nobody else knows, so I get it at reasonable prices. But apart from that, I think it is very, very important that whether it is coffee or chocolate, not tea, at least in tea we have something called Darjeeling, but whether it is coffee or chocolate or cocoa, that a country in the southern Mediterranean, Italy, or France, or Germany, or in America, or the United States, should determine how coffee is made, how it is consumed, and how it is branded. So we do need to work with the entire coffee ecosystem, the Atal Innovation Mission, the Coffee Board, and coffee growers who understand best how to brand these things, on how to create, I'm resonating your words, one, not very far away hopefully, an Indian brand which we can aggressively market and jointly make sure that that brand is then known for coffee. There are many ways of doing this. The Vietnamese did it through opening a chain of coffee shops globally called Chun Nguyen. So Chun Nguyen is all over the world. It was initially subsidized by the Vietnamese government. Very soon, it began making money. Juan Valdez, which is a Colombian coffee company, they opened coffee shops all over the world, and now Juan Valdez is a brand. So we also, I think, need to start pushing back. All I would urge you is that this pushback starts in the city of Bangalore, since the coffee board is here. And let me get a commitment from this hotel tonight to Mr. Krishna and from every other hotel in this city that when you offer free coffee or even any kind of coffee, you will make sure that you point out to all your guests, Indian and foreign, that this is Indian coffee and it's a brand that we are proud of, and we're not going anywhere in making this brand a global leader. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Roy, for all your insights. Yeah. While the Indian coffee sector has grown in terms of the critical performance measures of production, productivity, and trade, it's imperative that the sector reviews its current status and develops a roadmap for a viable and sustainable future. Therefore, the Coffee Board has partnered with Ernst & Young to develop a roadmap for the Indian coffee sector. I now invite Mr. Amit Vatsyayan to share with us details of the study and the way forward. Mr. Vatsyayan.
I'm honored to share this the stage with some of the honored dignitaries today. Our guest, chief guest, Mr. Vijay Bhaskar, CEO of Coffee Board, Sri Vats Krishna Ji, Mr. R. Ramanan, the director of Atal Innovation Mission, and Sri Roy from Institute of Public Finance and Policy. Also amongst us, dignitaries, Sri Maheshwar Rao, the Secretary of Agriculture, Srimati Gunjan Krishna, the Commissioner MSME and MD KSIDC, and Sri Sharmanan, Director of Plantation. Ladies and gentlemen, coffee growers and colleague. Personally, it's a celebration time for coffee enthusiasts like me. By the way, I thought I was a coffee enthusiast till we went into the coffee quiz. And I realized I still need to know a whole lot more. At the outset, I would like to appreciate Sri Shivatsa Krishna for his vision and commitment to script a better growth story for Indian coffee sector by taking a fresh look at the scheme of things. Coffee sector today is at crossroads. We've got Indian coffee, which has been traditionally doing quite well as far as exports is concerned, but largely the coffee was positioned as a base for multiple coffees which we see as brands. Along with that, we have also seen that over the past few years, the Indian market of coffee is taking up, but is the rate of coffee uptake and the ecosystem which is required to support that, is it all there? That question is still being answered. So Shivatsa Krishna has been driving that, and I've personally had the pleasure of seeing how he's trying to bring about tie-ups such as with the Institute of Public Finance and Policy, as well as with Atal Innovation Mission. But not only with that, he's also trying to bring in partnership with global firms like Starbucks, Tata's, on looking at how more value add can happen for coffee within the country, which traditionally used to go out of the country even for basic value addition earlier. Similarly, he's also tying up with and in conversation with companies such as Amazon and Snapdeal to take the coffee to general buyer. And I think it's again very, very critical given the crossroads which I was mentioning the coffee sector finds itself in. There is a downward pressure on international coffee prices. There are other countries which are also jumping into the foray. We've got Vietnam, who's highly competitive, and we are seeing Indonesia also gearing up in terms of increasing its area under plantation as well as positioning its coffee. Along with that, we are also seeing significant amount of non-tariff barriers. Beyond the tariff barriers, especially in countries where Indian coffee used to be dependent on. And there are greater demands on things like traceability, especially when Indian coffee growers are trying to go for single origin coffee or specialty coffee. My friends, I don't need to tell you more about coffee. I'm sure you are having a first-hand experience of these challenges. But it's absolutely important to bring technology in this conversation and how we look at the future of coffee sector. So keeping that in mind, as EY, we look forward to collaborating with Coffee Board to realize its vision to transform the coffee sector for better. We will be working with Coffee Board to realize the vision which Shri Krishna has outlined of premiumization, entrepreneurship, as well as productivity enhancement by looking at what are the identified challenge when we are looking at the entire value chain. There are significant challenges, of course, at production level. Again, I don't need to go into issues about the rust or white stem borer challenges which farmers face, but there are significant issues about changing climate, but also as we go along the value chain in terms of processing and in terms of ability to position itself in the market, which currently exists for coffee growers. So we will be trying to take a look at that. We will be trying to take a look at what type of technology application will make it easier to both ensure that premium positions are achieved, but also to ensure both productivity enhancement and losses are curtailed, which currently tend to be the bane of Indian coffee growers. So we will be looking at production challenge, we will be looking at value chain challenge, we will be looking at the strategic positioning of Indian coffee, and finally leveraging technological intervention. And while proposing measures to overcome identified challenge, we'll also be looking at how do we strengthen the existing coffee, Indian coffee's position. Some of the strengths which we can already see is we have one of the best robustas in the world. We also do have high quality shade grown coffee, natural organic coffee, for example, grown in tracts like Araku, as well as enhancing domestic and international market sales. So the benefit of this approach I expected to be far reaching. Mr. Krishna spoke about how a very small percentage of the coffee comes to the farmers. We would be looking at how this can be changed, how some of the livelihood improvement of farmers and leading to doubling of their income can be achieved by, and also by promoting a greater agripreneurship in the sector, which will of course impact coffee sector in particular, but agribusiness sector at large, and which would in turn create more employment as well as greater tourism and the economic benefits associated with it. I, along with my team, look forward to this exciting assignment, and I once again thank Shri Shivatsa Krishna and the Coffee Board for giving EY the opportunity to lay out the roadmap to translate their vision into reality. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Amit. Ladies and gentlemen, after hearing all these speakers, you may agree that the partnerships and initiatives announced in today's event, as well as those which were launched with the Honorable Commerce Minister about a month ago, they all have the cumulative potential to release the Indian coffee sector on a higher trajectory, while also promoting inclusive growth and sustainable development. We have reached the end of this part of today's event. So on behalf of the Coffee Board, I would like to thank all the distinguished guests for sharing their ideas and thoughts with us. I would like to thank all the speakers for being able to make it here today. Also thank the distinguished guests, including Mr. Maheshwar Rao, Ms. Gunjan, and also Mr. Sharvanan for, you know, being with us today. Also thank all the representatives of coffee growers associations, central and state governments, financial institutions, coffee businesses, research institutions, and all others who have participated in this event. I'd also especially like to thank the sponsors of today's event, who have been extremely responsive and liberal to the Coffee Board's request for support. Sincere thanks to Alana Sons Private Limited, one of India's largest coffee exporters, especially of green coffee, for sponsoring the first and second prizes of today's quiz and also a part of the event promotion costs. Thanks to Tata Coffee Plantation Trails for sponsoring the third prize of today's quiz. Also, we are glad that a number of leading names in the coffee sector have supported this event by providing gift hampers. In alphabetical order, Bayer's Coffee, Coffee Day Global, Continental Coffee, Coca-Cola Georgia, McCafe, Nestle India, Starbucks India, and Tata Coffee. We sincerely thank you all for extending generous support to organize this event. We also thank Georgia, Nestle India, Hindustan Unilever, and Pradeep Stainless for serving freshly prepared pure coffee during this event. I'm sure you'd have released it. We also thank the media, Mr. Vikram of Quizaru, and Hotel Shangri-La for all the cooperation extended. So we come to the end of this part of the event, and we'll now proceed with the quiz. Thank you all.
The coffee chain which was acquired by a multinational, Costa Coffee was acquired by Coca-Cola. Costa Coffee was acquired by Coca-Cola for £3.9 billion. The branch of Islam which many historians ascribe to the spread of coffee across the world. You can give me the answer. Please don't be so shy. Sufi is correct. I'll be starting the quiz shortly. I hope you don't remain silent during the quiz. Kaffa is from which country? Ethiopia. Looks like you haven't been drinking the coffee outside. All fallen asleep. Yeah. The hills I showed you. Baba Budangiri, I'll also give it for Chandragiri. Chandragiri or Baba Budangiri, both correct. If you've written both, I'll give you the points. The cocktail. Did anybody get the cocktail? I have a small gift for anybody who got the cocktail. Not the Negroni. Anybody else? Not the espresso martini. What do you say, sir? Americano is correct. Americano. Can we get a prize over to this table here? Yeah. Americano to buy us coffee. The CES committee, the coffee CES committee, what change did it set up? India Coffee House. The roasts, the two roasts I was looking for in increasing order of temperature. Blonde. I like the way you think. The two, New England is one, and the second is New England and French. New England and French, if you've got both, are giving you a prize. The month of the year where you see the least coffee sales? January. Why January? Why January? If you give me why January, I'll give you a prize. People prefer drinking alcohol. I'm with you on that. It's all the resolutions we make. All the resolutions we make. We'll drink less coffee. We'll learn to play the guitar. Yeah. The TV show Coffee with Karan. Yes. And the two places in the USA. I mentioned USA very specifically. You give me both the places, give you a prize.
Hawaii and California.
Puerto Rico. Hawaii and Puerto Rico. Part of the United States of America. Puerto Rico is a part of the USA. The first outlet of CCD was set up on Brigade Road. Brigade Road, and thank God CCD got that correct. Nahi to aapka promotion ruk jata. $4 for an espresso is dumb. Who did that add? McDonald's. McDonald's, I'll give it for McCafe also. The five GI estates, Baba Budangiri, Araku Valley, Coorg, Chikmagalur, and Wayanad are the five estates applied for GI status. The egg coffee, Vietnam is correct. The egg coffee comes from Vietnam. And the Italian cuisine element, which the chef mixed it up with, was olive oil. Olive oil. Uber Eats, number one city in the country. A prize for that. Indore, can you get a prize over to you? Indore is correct. Indore. Did you guess that or did you read the survey? You didn't write it, but you Googled it later. You didn't Google it. It's okay, I trust you, you got a prize. The Japanese coffee shop is called a?
Kisaten.
Kisaten. Kisaten. Not Kaiseki, not Kaisai, Kisaten. One More Cup of Coffee for the Road was sung by Bob Dylan. And the coffee Carriariana or Carrier Coffee is a species which is a caffeine-free coffee found in which country of the world? Cameroon. Cameroon. Can we get another prize for you? Yeah. Cameroon. Lovely. That wraps up the oral part of the prelims. The coffee shop in Friends is Central Perk, a traditional style of coffee shop found mostly in Vietnam, in Malaysia, Brunei, Singapore, and Indonesia. Anybody got that? Who said Kopitam? Kopitam, can we get a prize to this gift team here? Kopitam. David Fincher's movie masterpiece is Fight Club. A term used for infused cold brew is nitro. The Kopitam over to that table over there, the coffee house or Adda. Italy's first Starbucks opened in Milan. The hill station in Visakhapatnam is Araku Valley. And the word used for a tasting session for brewed coffee, cupping. Cupping is correct. Nestle took a majority stake in Blue Bottle Coffee. In Blue Bottle Coffee, Nestle recently took a majority stake. Baba Budan naturally introduced coffee beans from Yemen to Chikmagalur. And which company developed the drone? IBM. IBM. I used to work for IBM a long, long time ago. Yeah. And back in the day, people used to criticize IBM as being the full form for its better manual. Times have changed. So the 8 teams which are through to the finals, we have 8 teams, and it was fairly close when it went down to the wire. There were a couple of teams which could have crept up in there. We have 8 rounds in the finals, plus a couple of interesting tweaks, and we'll be calling you up one team by one team so that we can have the draw of lots. Do we have, we have 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Could I request all the teams in the front row to please head back so then we can get these occupied by the teams? Yeah. Yeah. As they come up. Team number 8. I'm announcing it in reverse order. Team number 8. Let's have a big round of applause for Coca-Cola Georgia. Coca-Cola Georgia. Stay where you are for the moment. We'll be doing a draw of lots. Stay where you are. Coke Georgia. Yeah. We're getting out these chits to you so you can pick your spot. In 7th place is Padi, P-A-D, Padiv, Padiv. In 7th place is P-A-D. We have, in 6th place, we have a late bloomer who came in literally at the last minute, Cod Road Cabal. The Cod Road Cabal, a quizzing team, or a team of quizzers, is Cod Road Cabal. We have 2 teams in a joint 4th. We've got the government of Karnataka, a big hand, big round of applause for them. And Coffee House or Adda. Coffee House or Adda are both tied with government of Karnataka in a joint 4th. Team number 3 is Coffee Growers Nilgiri. Coffee Growers Nilgiri, congratulations. Team number 2 is Frappalicious. Frappalicious, where are you? Over here. And team number 1, a massive round of applause for our team number 1, which scored a mammoth 190 points. The bloggers, yeah, 190 points, congratulations. Yeah, 190 points. Teams will sit from 1 to 8, so team number 1 comes here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So team number 1 here, and you can figure out where you're sitting after that. Our 8 teams in the finals are Coca-Cola Georgia, Padiv, Cod Road Cabal, Government of Karnataka, Coffee House or Adda, and Coffee Growers Nilgiri, Frappalicious, and the Bloggers. Okay, all done. Kane ka bol de. 10 minutes. Team number two is pad. Just pad, right? Not pad if. Where did the if come in from?
We also have an India Foundation.
You also have an India Foundation, but you're not it. That's not you. Okay. Team number three is I need a name. I can't call you this. I'll call you Mab. Give me a name. No, a team name. A team name. Think, yeah. Team number four is Coffee Growers Nilgiri. Thank you so much. Team number five is the Cordroad Cabal. Team number six is Frappalicious. Can we get a name here? Got a marker? Can write Frappalicious. Team number six is Frappalicious. Team number seven is Government of Karnataka. And team number eight is Coca-Cola Gia. Apart from the team, apart from the question which the teams don't answer, which I'm hoping they're not too many of, the other questions specifically for the audience. So all of you all who have stayed back from the prelims, thank you so much, and we hope to reward your patience very handsomely with some lovely gift hampers and gift boxes from all the sponsors of this wonderful quiz and the coffee board. Yeah. Okay. Everyone, and welcome back to the finals of Prashnotri, the coffee quiz. It's no surprise that we wake up and smell the coffee and not anything else. Yeah. Legend has it that Kaldi, a goat herd in Ethiopia, was surprised to find his goats unusually active after eating bunches of wild cherries. Probably one of the few instances of mankind saying that if it's good for a goat, it's good for us. Yes. Since Kaldi's epiphany, who by the way is immortalized in Ethiopia, there's a chain of fast food restaurants named as Kaldi's in Ethiopia, stimulants have evolved considerably, but coffee has not lost its place, and today is the second most traded commodity in the world after petroleum. It's a privilege for me and Rajat Gulati to be here today to help ring in International Coffee Day via this coffee quiz. We had a preliminary round earlier in the day with 19 teams, and the eight of you all here on stage know what you all went through to be here in the finals. Coffee has had a checkered history and has spread around the world in the most amazing ways, from it being a gift fit for a king, with the mayor of Amsterdam presenting Louis XIV, the Sun King, with the tree which came to be known as the Noble Tree and which was planted on the Ile de Bourbon, to the Brazilian who bedded the young French wife of the governor of French Guyana, who was thus persuaded to smuggle him some coffee beans, which was possibly the start of Brazil's journey to becoming the largest coffee-producing country in the world. As Dusty Springfield sang, just a little bit of loving early in the morning beats a cup of coffee. Well, as the Brazilians showed us, you could have both. And before we start the quiz, I'd like to end with these lines from a famous author and also a coffee farmer. It was hard work to keep it going. We were never rich on the farm, but a coffee plantation is a thing that gets hold of you and does not let you go. A worthy tribute, I think, to all the coffee growers of India. Yeah. And especially those who've had their livelihood, if not worse, affected in the catastrophic floods recently. So let's get the ball rolling in the finals. The rules. Yes, there are some rules, which we will follow now and then. We've got 8 rounds in the finals, so 64 questions, plus we have 4 special questions which we'll be serving out to the team. So these are items of food and drink which have a coffee linkage, and which will be served to all the teams. So you all have a chance, and I hope there's nobody in any team who doesn't drink alcohol. Yeah? And plus a piece of food for one of the teams. Right. Audience, please hold on. There are lots and lots of questions for some very attractive gift hampers, so please stay back. We've got questions after each round, and not just at the back of the quiz. We have one round in the middle, which is a buzzer round. All the teams have buzzers on your table. I'll show the question on the screen. The first team to hit the buzzer and get called out has to answer the question. If you get it right, it's plus 10. If you get it wrong, it's minus 5. Those questions don't pass. We'll follow the infinite bounds format. So what that means is if I ask the question to team number 2, it goes around to team number 5 who answers it. The next question doesn't go to team number 3. It goes to team number 6. So in infinite bounds, I don't go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I ask the question to the next team who's answered the previous question. So that's what we mean by the infinite bounds format. So it shouldn't theoretically matter where you're sitting or if some team is blocking you from the answers you know. Okay, there are participation certificates and hampers for all the teams in the prelims. I have this announcement to just come in. Infinite bound format, and no use is to be made of any manual or electronic aids. The quizmaster's decision is final. All the teams ready? With 6:30 exactly, we hope to be wrapping up by about 7:30, 7:45, and handing the prizes by then. Good to go? All charged up? Yeah? Let's get the ball rolling. Round number one is called Morning Brew, just to get you started. Team number one is Coffee House or Adda. And I request the audience, please, you might know the answer, just come on screen. Please, don't shout out the answer. You'll get your chance in case somebody doesn't know it in the teams on stage. Yeah, because we have very few spare questions, and these questions have taken a lot of time to prepare. Question number one. Bangalore-based tennis player has his own coffee estate in Coorg. I request the audience to please have your patience. We'll come back to you in case nobody gets it on stage. Do you have an answer, Coffee House or Adda? Your time is counting down.
Rohan Bopanna
gets you 10 points. Rohan Bopanna is the correct answer. 10 points for Coffee House or Adda. Question number two to Pad. Just Pad, yeah? Question number two. Which global quick service restaurant chain, which is also present in India, in a bid to rebrand itself as it shifts focus to beverages as a part of its portfolio, dropped a very major part of its brand name? Which?
Dunkin' Donuts?
Dunkin' is correct. Dunkin' Donuts. So Dunkin' Donuts dropped the donuts in their brand name, which is a massive part of their branding, showing their commitment to coffee as a beverage they're focusing on. 10 points to Padif. Thank you very much. 10 points to Padif. Next question to, what am I calling you? Filter copy. Question number three. At the 1932 LA Olympics, how was Brazil's participation enabled by coffee? In the 1932 LA Olympics, Brazil's participation was enabled by coffee. How? Were they sponsors? You're asking me?
No, I'm telling you.
You're telling me? Okay. No, they weren't sponsors. It's passing on to coffee growers Nilgiri.
Just a random guess.
Please, I love guesses.
Yeah, so, all right. So the participants really couldn't afford the ship fare in
okay.
1932. Along with some coffee sacks, they sat and came to the States.
Along with some?
Coffee sacks. Bags of coffee, which was being exported.
So they sailed on them?
Yeah, sailed with them.
And how did that help them get to, what is the connection between?
Essentially, stowaway types. Like the ship that was taking the coffee.
Oh, they stored away. They stowed away on the ship which was transporting the athletes to, yeah. God Road Cabal. They carried coffee and they sold it along the way to pay for their voyage. 10 points, brilliant. They couldn't afford to send their athletes, so you were close, you were getting there, but you got into stowaway. Yeah, no, guessing is great. 10 points to Cod Road Cabal. The next question, because they answered it, comes to Frappalicious. Frappalicious, your question on screen. The first round is purposely called Morning Brew. It's stuff which you should lap up very quickly. What are you going with?
Monsooning.
I'm looking for a specific answer. They give that? Okay, I'll give that to you. Monsooning. 10 points to Frappalicious. GOK, your question. In the world of coffee drinks, what's described as harmless?
Decaf.
decaf coffee is harmless and also no fun. Would you agree with that? Are you coffee drinkers? You don't agree with that? Yeah, so you basically no good coffee. 10 points to government of Karnataka. The next question over to Coca-Cola Georgia. Your question? What type of coffee drink owes its name to its similarity in appearance to the hoods of the robes worn by a particular order of monks?
Cappuccino?
The cappuccino by the Capuchin monks. Cappuccino coffee, which is linked to the Capuchin monk order, their hood is very similar to the robe, the froth created from that. So it goes around now to Coffee House or Adda? Coffee House or Adda? What did Jerry Baldwin, Zeb Siegel, and Gordon Bowker start?
Starbucks.
Starbucks. Starbucks is correct. They began Starbucks before Howard Schultz, who was an employee of theirs, decided to take it over from them. He saw the vision because originally Starbucks was just a retail store. It wasn't a cafe serving coffee. And Howard Schultz visited Italy and had an epiphany about what the coffee culture was all about. So he came back and persuaded them to sell Starbucks to him. He had set up his own chain of Italian coffee stores by then called Il Giornale. Starbucks is correct. Question to Padif, which is the last question of the first round.
Irish coffee.
Irish coffee. Irish coffee gets you 10 points at the end of the first round. We're keeping going. We've got the next question to filter copy. Your question. Can I have the slide up, please? Oh, sorry. Audience questions first. Audience. Barista. Barista is correct. Can we have a prize for the gentleman over there? Barista. Gentleman in the light blue shirt here. Second question for the audience. And remember, we don't just have questions on coffee. The audience also have a fair mix of questions. Something from Bollywood. Just for the audience, please. Lutera. Lutera is... Lutera, a prize over here. Lutera, our last question. Can I have the... Question number three, also Bollywood. Audience? Ertiga. Ertiga is correct. I heard it first. That's the Maruti Ertiga, the gentleman in the black T-shirt here. Gets the third audience prize. The Ertiga. Can I get the switch back here? Okay, filter copy. Ready? Our second round is called Coffee Plus Plus. So it's other beverages apart from coffee. Other beverages or food items? Let me be a little more specific. Other beverages or food items? Criollo, Forastero, Trinitario and Nacional. We're stepping up a gear now after the first round. Are the four main types of what? Food or beverage? I said coffee plus plus, so. Please, sir, I request if you not answer. Do you have a guess? There's no negative marking. Can you give me one guess, please?
Wine.
Not wine. Coffee growers, Nilgiri. You have a guess?
Rice.
Not rice. They said rice. Cod Road Cabal?
Coffee liquor.
Coffee liquor. The four main types of coffee liquor, Criollo, for us, I think not. Frappelicious. Frappelicious.
Paella.
Paella. Paella, okay, that's a leap of faith. Government of Karnataka. GOK, take a guess. California Dreaming. Marijuana. You can say it. Pasta, pasta is wrong. Coke, Georgia.
Cocoa or cacao?
The cacao bean is correct. 10 points. The cacao bean, lovely. 10 points. The four main types of the cacao bean. Criollo, Forastero, Trinitario, and Nacional. And because of Coke Georgia's benevolence. The next question comes back to Coffee House Radha. Coffee House Radha, your question. In 1930, Haddon Sundblom drew the definitive version of this person. It's your question. You can take the answer.
Just one part you want.
I just want who the person, yeah, whom did they draw?
This is the red Santa Claus.
The red Santa Claus, I'll give it to you. That's Santa Claus. So Haddon, the Santa Claus, which we all see nowadays, the big guy with the beard was originally made for a Coca-Cola ad. So we have a debt to Coke. Thank you, Coke, for that depiction. 10 points to Coffee House Radha. Next question comes back to Ped. Ped, who is this famous personality? He owned the most prosperous and successful distillery in the United States, aided by a Scottish plantation manager. And they've recently revived this distillery. Take a guess and go for a...
Johnny Walker?
Johnny Walker, United States, plantation owner. Filter copy. The distillery is renovated, whiskey is being made again, and it's very, very expensive whiskey. I can't afford it. Not Jack Daniels, they said Jack Daniels. I had Johnny Walker, Jack Daniels.
Macallan
is again Scotland. Cord Road Cabal.
Jameson,
all the way from Ireland to America. Frappalicious.
George Washington.
George Washington, the first president of the United States, was a whiskey distiller. So it's an honorable profession. 10 points for Frappalicious. Next question to the governor of Karnataka. GOK, in which Hindi movie, which Bollywood movie, would you find this brand of beer called Gulabo?
I'm just taking a guess. Is this Shole Gulabo?
Not Shole. Nice try. They said Shole. Can I get the audience? Please. Sir, we'll come back to you. We'll reward your enthusiasm. Don't worry. Coke, Georgia. Sharabi, Shole, Sharabi. All these shirts are going out. Can I get the slide back on the screen, please? Yeah. Coffee House Radha. Which Hindi movie?
Say, Gangs of Wasseypur.
Gangs of Wasseypur.
Matru ki Bijli ka Mandola.
Matru ki Bijli ka Mandola. Lovely. Matru ki Bijli ka Mandola has a brand of beer called Gulabo. John, did you know that? 10 points to Pad. Next question to filter copy again. Well, we did have John Walker, Johnny Walker, come up in a previous answer from one of the teams. And before John Walker started blending Scotch whiskey, because Scotch whiskey is a type of Scotch whiskey, is a blended whiskey, he was blending something else. What was he blending? Shivatsa, should be taking part. What was Johnny Walker blending before he turned to Scotch?
Coffee.
Not coffee. I said coffee plus. Coffee growers.
Tea.
Tea is correct. So Johnny Walker, you know what profession Johnny Walker had? What was his profession? He was a grocer. He ran a grocery store in Kilmarnock, and he used to blend tea and sell that blended tea. And then he got the idea of blending whiskey, and that's how Johnny Walker came into being. So such a famous brand and such a simple origin. 10 points. Did you guess that or did you work it out? Perfect guess. I love you. Great guess. Lovely guess. 10 points to Coffee Growers Nilgiri. Cord Road Cabal. Your question. Maya Hoel is a goddess and a personification plant which yields a very famous beverage. Just on the side, she has 400 breasts.
Tequila.
Tequila. Tequila is correct. 10 points to Cord Road Cabal. Frappalicious. Robert Fortune published his book, an account of his espionage mission to China. What did he do?
So the idea was to introduce tea into British colonies, so he got some tea from Shanghai and all into Assam, then that's how Indian tea distributed.
He smuggled tea into India from China. I'll give that to you. 10 points again to Frappalicious, who's lapping it up. They like their tea. And the last question in this, the 16th question. This very popular Indian non-alcoholic beverage takes its name from two Urdu words.
Ruh Afza.
Lovely. 10 points. 10 points. Government of Karnataka liked the Ruh Afza. Yeah? At the end of the 16th question, what are the scores? We've got Coffee House Radha on 30 points. Yes. Pad on 30. Okay. Coffee Growers Nilgiri are on 10. Cord Road Kabbal are on 20. Frappalicious are 30. GOK is 20, Coke Georgia is 20. So it's very close. At the end of two rounds, we have six rounds to go, plus some special rounds. The field is pretty wide open with three teams tied in first place on 30 points each. Our third round starting up now, coming into Coke Georgia, your question. I'll reverse direction at the end of four rounds. Can I get the slide back, please? Coke Georgia, your question. And so we're back to coffee now, but this is just a strange brew of some questions. And this is the toughie. Bacon, eggs, broccoli, and coffee. The regular diet of two holders of the same world record at different times. Are you thinking wrestlers? Kabaddi players? No. Take a guess. It's one of those which either you know it or you don't, or you can make the most fabulous guess ever, which I will reward you handsomely with. Can I pass you Coke Georgia? Take a guess. You have a mic? I'll have to pass you Coke.
Sprint, track sprint,
world record at for sprint. Coffee House or Adda?
That's wrong, you said.
They said, yeah, sprint, world record in sprints is wrong.
Okay, we'll
see. Bacon, eggs, broccoli, and coffee. All my favorite food groups.
See the world's strongest man.
World's strongest man, yeah. Not the world's strongest man. No, not at all.
Weightlifting,
no. Wrestling, no. Wrestling, filter copy said wrestling. Wine Growers, Karnataka, you want to take another guess like you did for tea? Tea worked out.
Guessing again.
Yeah.
The guys who climbed all the 8,000.
Climbed all the 8,000, no. Cord Road Kabbal.
Fastest to run a mile.
Fastest to run a mile. Frappalicious.
You think this is most number of Olympic gold medals swimming?
Olympic gold medals, Government of Karnataka?
Are these astronauts in the International Space Station? Two of them, highest.
Astronauts in the International Space Station, no. The first question, which has passed all the way around without any correct answers. You can try for a prize, sure. Sumo, no. Audience? Grand Slam, no. Okay, the clue only for the audience. These are two of the world's longest living animals. Which animal? Cats. The world's two longest living cats. Both lived to that age because of bacon, eggs, broccoli, and coffee. A cat called Cream Puff lived to 38 years. She drank coffee every morning. Yeah. And Grandpa Rex Allen lived to 34 years. Can we have a prize for the lady over here? Next question to Coffee House or Adda, your question? That was your question, right? Coke Georgia? Coffee House or Adda, your question? One of the fastest growing Indian coffee brands is a brand called Blue Tokai. In ancient Malabari, what does Tokai mean? And I want a very specific answer.
I will say this is like a mountain reference to Nilgiris. So.
Mountain reference to Nilgiris, bad. They said a mountain referenced wheel grease, which is incorrect.
Goat?
Gold.
Goat.
Goat. Like the Caldi, the goat herd. So this is the blue goat of the Malar. Nice. Filter copy. I need a very specific answer. Give me one answer and a specific answer. We're in the finals here. Pick one. They said peacock. Coffee growers, Nilgiri. And I'm looking for a specific answer. We're in the finals, so I can't afford to be too lenient. Coffee growers, Nilgiri.
Mountain?
They said mountain. Want to take another guess? This, you said mountain, right? They said mountain, yeah. Trust in me. Passing you, Quad Road Cabal. Bean, they said bean. So, so it's a blue bean.
The coastline, basically.
The coastline, Frappalicious.
Frappalicious? It's not a mountain, but a hill.
But a hill, huh? Tokai is basket, the blue basket, Coca-Cola, Georgia.
Wild fowl.
I'm coming back to you. I request the audience to please hold on. I'll come back to you in a minute or two. Coffee House Radha. You said mountain, sorry. Okay, I'm going to come back. Audience, please. Filter copy. I'm going to give you a chance to clarify your answer. You said peacock. Can you be more specific? The plume of the peacock is correct. The plume of the peacock is what Tokai means, Malabari, the plume of the peacock. Filter copy opens their account with an answer. Nicely done, yeah, which passed all the way around. So we were fated to answer that question. Did somebody know that from the audience? The gentleman over here, I'll trust in you. The plume of the peacock. Can we get a prize over to him, please? Yeah. The plume of the peacock. Do you drink blue Tokai, sir? Do you drink blue Tokai? No? Okay. Never in your life. They got plumes. The next question is to grow Nilgiri. Famous book, even more famous movie, which won a lot of Oscars, including the Best Movie Oscar in 1985. And based on the true account of a coffee farmer. Wine growers, Nilgiri. Coffee grows Nilgiri, I mean. Coffee grows Nilgiri? What's your guess? I'll need to pass you. Tarzan, no?
The color purple?
Frappalicious?
Out of Africa.
Out of Africa, written by Karen Blixen. Isaac Dennison, Karen Blixen, Out of Africa, played by Meryl Streep in the movie. 10 points to Frappalicious. Next question, can we have the screen back, please? Next question to Government of Karnataka. Government of Karnataka is on a roll. Let's see if they get this. I think they will. I have this feeling. Don't prove me wrong, GOK. You can take this logically. When he attached the Arabica suffix to coffee in 1753, he unintentionally hijacked Ethiopia's claim to being the birthplace of coffee. Who are we talking about? Is correct. Linnaeus. Carl Linnaeus is correct. The gentleman who gave the botanical names for plants. the nomenclature genie, 10 points to government of Karnataka for Carl Linnaeus, who defined Cafe Arabica. Next question to Coca-Cola Georgia. Coca-Cola Georgia. Just happened. What was the name of the local chain, which is now changing its name? It's being forced to change its name due to a suit filed by an international chain. This is founded by Sanmeet Singh Kalra. Hardcastle, no, not really. Yeah. Coffee House Radda?
Yeah. Earlier it was Sardar Baksh, now it's Sardar Ji Baksh.
Yeah. I'll give that to you. Sardar Baksh is correct. Sardar Baksh was sued by Starbucks. That's the logo of Sardar Baksh Coffee. Indian ingenuity at work. You were in the wrong places, yeah? We talked about developing an Indian brand of coffee, but this is not the way to go about it. 10 points for Coffee House Radda. Next question to Pad. Judge Elihu M. Burl, a judge in LA County Superior Court, recently sent shivers down the spine of the coffee industry in the UK. Why?
Excise.
What about excise? He lowered excise, increased excise,
increased.
He banished excise. You're in a quiz, I need a specific answer. Just don't say excise.
Now I have to take a guess.
Now you're confused with excise. Filter copy. What did the judge do?
I'm guessing.
Please.
There was some ruling about coffee and cancer. That coffee could cause cancer.
That is correct, that coffee can cause cancer. His ruling sent shivers down the spine, and 10 points to filter copy. For a nice big hamper, what chemical did he ascribe this to? What chemical in coffee did he ascribe this to?
Acrylamide
is correct. 10 points. Not 10 points, sorry. A gift for you. A gift for Coke Georgia. Next question to coffee growers Nilgiri. What does the word affogato literally mean?
Hot and cold.
Hot and cold. God wrote Cabal. How's your Italian? Not too good, I'm guessing.
Sweet and bitter.
Sweet and bitter, hot and cold.
Drowned.
Affogato means drowned because the espresso is literally drowned in the ice cream. 10 points to Frappalicious. And Government of Karnataka, your question. It looks like you have this nice relationship going on, right? They answer, then you answer. Are you guys sharing the first and second place? I sense a conspiracy here, a cabal. Your question, Government of Karnataka. It could be any one of two terms. I'll go with either of them. What's the term used for? I'll give it to you for intercropping, but I don't like answers which start with basically, because I know you're reading down a dodgy path. You had it at intercropping. 10 points for Government of Karnataka with intercropping or cross-cropping. 10 points for Government of Karnataka. And audience, Deadpool 2. Brad Pitt had a cameo role in the movie. What did he charge Ryan Reynolds for the role? A cup of coffee, lovely. A cup of coffee, one cup of coffee for appearing in Deadpool 2 for all of 3 seconds, yeah? So not a very expensive cup of coffee. Another question for the audience. Audience, what two-word term was used to describe the IPL 7 finals in 2014?
No, it was linked to the owners of the two teams. The owners of the two teams had a link to the description of the finals. The owners were Shahrukh and Preeti Zinta. Can you give me the name of the Veer Zara? The Veer Zara finals. Can we get a prize over there? The Veer Zara finals is correct. And cricket now. Not Kapil Dev. The test of my life. Which Indian cricketer? Yes, sir. No, not Rahul Dravid. The test of my life. So he was battling something. He was fighting something. Yuvraj Singh. Yuvraj Singh. I heard it from this lady here. The test of my life by Yuvraj Singh. And we're going to get... It'll be a debilitating influence. Audience round, yeah. I'll buy you a beer at the bar. How does that sound? Government of Karnataka is looking thirstily at that glass. It has alcohol. I'm sure the Shangri-la has done right by us. Yeah. In any case, the other teams can start figuring out. It's got four main ingredients. Four. So don't go over four. Don't give me five and say three were correct, so you give me points.
The first four.
First four, yeah, yeah. Don't write one laundry list of 10, please. How's the drink? Is it nice? You don't drink? Can I have it? No, it's okay. Just joking. If you don't drink, I'll send it to the other team once you're done with it. Oh, they're drinking. nothing more than the points. So you get three, you'll get points in any case. Get one more and you're there. Can I have a toffee? I'm sorry for the wait. Can you fold it up, please? What's your team name on it?
What if we get three right ones?
I'll give it to you.
Okay, how many points for
10. 10 points for 3 out of 4. Ask them to make two more portions of the other two. Ah, thanks. You have it? You have your answer? You're still drinking. You have your answer? Angustia. Okay, I have a few for the audience while we're waiting for the drink to come up. Audience, we talked about Coffee with Karan earlier on. In the sixth season of Coffee with Karan, who were Karan Johar's guests in the first episode? For the audience, sixth season of Coffee with Karan, who were Shah Rukh and Alia is wrong. Alia and Deepika is correct. Alia and Deepika, can we get a prize to this lady here in white? Alia and Deepika. Another question, Coffee with Karan, for the audience. In 2004, who were the first ever guests of Karan Johar on Coffee with Karan? Shah Rukh and Kajol. I'll give it to you. You already got one. Yeah. Shah Rukh and Kajol. Are you all Friends fans here, the TV show? Well, on the TV show Friends, the cafe is called Central. No points for that. What's the name of the barista? Gantha over there. Gantha, can we get a prize to the lady over there? How did Gantha get the job? How did Gantha get the job in Friends to be the barista at Central Park? By applying for interview. Can you get a creative guess from the audience? How did Gantha get the job to be a barista in Central Park? In the TV show Friends, how did he clinch the job? He was? Only. I'll give that to you, to operate the machine. He was the only guy who knew how to operate the coffee machine, the espresso machine. So it pays to prepare for your interview. Can I get the prize over here? Yeah. A little tougher now. What's the real name for the cup, for your espresso cup? What's the real name? Who said that? Demitasse over here, a demitasse cup. What does demitasse literally mean? Half cup. Can we get something over there? The gentleman in the back. Demitasse literally means half cup. Thank you, Rajat. The last. The world's most expensive coffee. The world's most expensive coffee is the Kopi Luwak. Which animal? Civet. She said it first. She was lucky I was right. Can you specify the kind of civet? The palm civet. Over here, the lady here. The palm civet is correct. Hello. Coke, Georgia, how's it going? You done? I like the fact that you're savoring your cocktail. And GOK has already finished their drink. They want another one. One more. Okay, can you put your team name on the top also, please? Audience, want some more prizes? Yeah. I had a question earlier about the Americano. There's also a Hollywood movie called The Americano. Who was the lead star in that? I had a question earlier about The Americano. It's a cocktail and also a coffee drink. There's also a Hollywood movie made called The Americano, or The American. Who was the lead star in The Americano? And if you know your Hollywood stars, you can take a guess and get a hamper. How many Hollywood stars do you know? No. George Clooney is the correct answer. And Governor of Karnataka, can we have your sheet, please? Yeah, thank you. And to all you, Mysore Nuggets, that's a lovely name. Mysore Nuggets is GOK been renamed. Okay, we've got these last two sheets in. Who got the last question before this round finished?
Team 7,
Governor of Karnataka. So next question goes to you folks, Kokkola, Georgia. Georgia. So we're just exploring coffee culture around the world. Vienna is a country very, very famous for its cafes and cafe culture. And Kolschitsky opened the Dash Dash Cafe in Vienna in 1686. A modern-day coffee enterprise was so inspired by this cafe that they named themselves after him. Yeah, your question, Coke Georgia. Kolschitsky played a lead role in rebelling the Turks from Vienna. I think he got some message across the Polish troops. And as a reward, he got these sacks of beans which the Turks left behind and set up the coffee. What was the name of his cafe? Coca Georgia, I have to pass you. Take a guess. Lavaza is wrong. Not Lavaza, Coffee House Radha.
Taking a guess, it's Green Bean Cafe.
Green Bean Cafe.
Green Bean. Because they left behind green beans.
They left behind green beans. Nicely worked out, but incorrect. Pad. We've had Lavaza, we've had Green Bean. Pad, got a guess?
Costa,
no. Filter copy.
Barista.
Blue Bottle. Blue Bottle is correct. Blue Bottle Coffee. So Blue Bottle Coffee, recently massive stake got taken over. So Blue Bottle Coffee opened up by 10 points to Wine Growers Karnataka. Next question to Cord Road Cabal. Cord Road Cabal. The history of this famous Indian coffee estate traces back to 1832 when Augustine & Co. built it. After this, it changed hands several times to its current owners. And there's a particular tribe called the Lambanis who pick the berries from this estate. Does anybody want any clues? Does somebody know it? If any team has a pretty good answer, then they shouldn't ask avoid clues. Got a guess? You'll take the clue. I like your train of thought. Frappalicious. No, I'm not giving a clue. I'll come back after.
Guessing that it could be Kalmane in Chikmagalur.
Kalmane in Chikmagalur. Government of Karnataka? You okay? Tata Gudi, Kokkola, Georgia? Araku Estates, Coffee House Radha?
Sakleshpur, the estate.
Sakleshpur Estate. Pad? Pad, I'm passing pad. Filter copy? No, Wine Growers, Nilgiris?
Is this Sakama Group, Sakama Estates?
Not the Sakama Estates. I'm coming back with a clue. Hold on, gentlemen, I'll come back to you. And I'm coming back with a clue for 5 points. This estate is now owned by Cafe Coffee Day, the current owners. And it's extremely famous for its single origin coffee, which you'll see written on the label. So you'll see the name of the estate also written on the label. The name of the estate is written in the label, but in English?
Kota's estate.
Prepalicious. This is 5 points.
Amalgamated bean.
Government of Karnataka. Passing you. Kokla, Georgia. I'm passing you. Coffee House Radda. I have somebody in the audience who knows this, so I need to move fast. They're getting greedy. Getting in. Pad.
Nilgiris?
Not Nilgiris.